Monaco shows up late to class with nothing more than her swimsuit on.
And the otaku go wild!
And for her tardiness, or maybe she just doesn't like her bubbly personality, the teacher then proceeds to poke her boobs with her bamboo blade.
Alright, it's time for me to make fun of this scene by imitating it, and I'll do it with my trusty mung! That's right. I don't have my manga katana anymore.
Surprisingly, the opening scene actually had a purpose, to which the teacher says that the girl that she saved from drowning is okay, to which Monaco replies by...
What the hell was that? Was it some kind of catchphrase? Ooh, I know! Maybe she's a fan of that new anime series that came out, Poyo Poyo Kanzatsu Niki. Or maybe she's a fan of Jamie Kennedy. Circle, dot. I've got a million of them.
So apparently Monaco is a part of the Sweats Club.
And if it wasn't for the synopsis, I would have had a very different assumption as to what the Sweats Club was about.
Come on, what's wrong with you, boy? I don't see any perspiration on your brow.
I can't do it, sir. It's my Irish blood. I just can't sweat.
Would Monaco, our founder, give up on such a little inconsistency as Irish blood? Now are you going to let austerity bring you down, or are you going to pull through for the Sweats Club for Monaco?
I can do it for Monaco!
So, what is the Sweats Club, you ask? Or Jersey Club? Well, it's kind of hard to say based on the first episode, but from what I can gather, since Monaco is the only member of the Sweats Club, I can only assume that the Sweats Club is all about participating in every other club and just being a basic overachiever.
And of course, this being a school life anime, they had to have at least one character that was an overachieving perfectionist.
Monaco encounters the girl that took her clothing and is actually wearing them right now, to which the girl then proceeds to strip in front of her.
If you were just going to return the clothing, then why were you wearing them? And in fact, if you hadn't have taken the clothing, then she wouldn't have come to school with just her swimsuit on.
Well, maybe she was just keeping the clothing safe in case someone would take them.
Oh, yeah, saving it from people just like her.
So obviously, from any normal person, this would react to them asking, "Hey, you bitch, why the hell did you take my clothing? Do you know what kind of hell I had to go through? Yeah, you got a sexy butt, but that still doesn't excuse you from taking my frickin' clothing
while I was going all Baywatch on that scene back there."
But of course, the bitch leaves before she can really let it all out. Monaco arrives home at her dad's surfing shop to find out that her sister has come over to visit.
Must be their special greeting for each other. Well, they must have that kind of relationship.
Pants 능해. Pants 능해.
Hi.
Hop. No. 動くな.
So they must have that kind of relationship.
And then after all that physical and sexual harassment, her sister then gets a call, hands her business card over to Monaco, and then just leaves with no other explanation as to why she did that.
Oh, I see. That's how it is. You bruise me up, you have your way with me, and then you leave without saying a word. Typical nature.
I am not a hug pillow.
One thing that you've probably noticed of this anime series is the number of very odd scenes. This one in particular.
Who are you again?
Finyeldo Seraphintio. Do
you have a nickname?
Landeiwa.
La!
Oh,
all right,
yes,
okay,
La! Yeah,
yeah,
three
La,
syllables.
Okay, I can remember
all right,
that. All right,
yeah, all right. Easy enough.
Wait, Lana's nowhere in her actual name.
Anata, roboto ni noreru?
Well, I already have my permit, but my dad won't let me pilot the robot on school days.
We next cut to...
Space!
Where we see that the Earth is about to be invaded by pretty boy aliens.
Isn't it always?
We next cut to... What was that? What is that? What's going on? Oh, we're back here again? What the heck is this? And why am I wearing different pants?
So then Monoko is dragged off to what? Wait a minute. Is that 3G headquarters from Gau Geiger? Meanwhile, Monoko's sister, who I found out is actually her cousin, invades Monoko's room and laments about her deceased aunt.
おばさん、窓かをロボットになんか乗せさせやしないから。はい。先輩のいとこの子来ちゃってますけど。
Oh, the irony!
So then Mariko then gets to meet this mech that she was never supposed to meet. And then, upon touching said forbidden mecha, she then experiences a traumatic flashback.
Son of a bitch! He shot me in the ass!
But then the enemy robot comes in, which suspiciously looks a lot like Zekrom from Pokemon Black and White. Heh, maybe the pilot's Nobunaga.
And so with this big imposing threat, the military over at 3G headquarters decides to send out their best high school girl to handle the situation. But... wait a minute, she doesn't have any military experience.
MangaMan, have you learned nothing from anime? School children always make the best pilots for complicated giant robots.
I can't argue with that.
とにかくすべてはこちらのコントロール下にある。ここから先、何があってもうろたえるなと伝えろ。
Okay, wait a minute. If they have the robot on remote control, then why do they even need a pilot in the first place? Let alone a teenage girl! Oh, audible gasp! She's getting murdered out there! Chief, what's your call?
Final fusion! Shonen!
Yokai! Final fusion! Program drive!
Final fusion!
Looking bright here. Oh, what is this?
Oh, I do believe she is making a comeback.
That's right. Oh, wait, wait, what is this?
Could it be? Let me tell you, brother, it would appear she's going for the German suplex.
Oh my God, by the balls of RoboCop. Oh, here it comes. Oh,
and there is the knockout. Let me tell you something, brother. I have never seen such a comeback in all my years in the World Robot Wrestling Federation. Oh, yeah.
So that was Rinne no Lagrange, and Honestly, for the anime series is not too bad, but it definitely has a rough start. It's a very unique case for a mecha genre series because it also has that level of school life slash slice of life. And it's not like this hasn't been new to the mecha genre before. There have been plenty of other series that have kind of explored that, but not really to this much of an extent. But there are a lot of things in this first episode that are really awkward and makes you scratch your head at. Like, why the hell did that blue-haired girl bark at her in that shower scene? It's these types of scenes that kind of are acting like a stumbling block, that kind of distracts you from the story at hand. It may be not the case for everyone, but it kind of was for me. Overall, Rinne no Lagrange was, an okay series, but not one that I have been watching, really. I only watched the first episode for this one, anyways. Tune in next time, when next I will...
Next time, MangaMan will preview Papa no Iyukoto o Kiki Nasai.
Wait, what was the name of that series?
I understand you were wounded. Where were you hit?
In the buttocks, sir.
Oh, that must be a sight. I'd kind of like to see that.